Hello, my dear students. Very good morning to all of you. Once again, I welcome you all to this TYBSC online lecture. Today, we are going to start new topic, that is last chapter of this semester, this industrial chemistry, cement and glass industry, which consisting of two different sections. One is cement section and second is the glass industry. What are the points we are discussing today in this lecture? That is cement chemistry, introduction of the cement industry, importance of the cement, definition and classification of the cement, that we are going to see in this lecture. This is the point, as I told, this whole chapter which having the two sections, cement industry and the glass industry. We started with the cement industry. As we know that if you see the history of the cement goes back to the Egyptian civilization, when calcinated impure gypsum was used to construct pyramids. Where from the cement is important building material, it is used for the construction of houses, buildings, roads, dams, bridges and so on. So, with this history, ancient years, for any construction, the clay, that is artificial cement, the clay material was used for the construction of buildings. Here, we can say the artificial cement, which consisting of calcium hydroxide, in 1924, an Englishman, Joseph Aspidin, successfully prepared artificial cement by the calcination of argillaceous material, that is calcium material, in the where we can see the large proportion of clay and sand mixed to each other, it forms a stone like structure. It is called as Portland cement, which is Portland cement exactly setting, it is resembled to the building stone of the obtained from the Portland area, that is near to the England. So therefore it is named as the Portland cement. Here we can see what are the importance of the cement. Cement is one of the significant material, important material, in which used for the building material nowadays. It is used in the construction of road, it is used in the construction of buildings, dams, bridges, etc. For the purpose of any construction, we use in the form of the paste with sand and water is called as the particular material. So that a mixture of cement, sand, gravel and water is called as the concrete, in which cement is the important material, which is a mixture of combination of argillaceous material as well as calcium material, that we can see here. How we can define the cement? Cement is a substance which when mixed with small amount of water sets to hard stone like substance in few hours with varying degree of strength and bonding properties. This is very important. Where cement is a substance, is a material, when it is mixed with amount of water, it sets like a stone like structure after a few hours or after some time with varying degree of strength and bonding properties is known as the cement. Where we can see cement, the several variety of cement we can see, they broadly they are classified on the basis of their composition as well as some of their strength. You can see here the different types of cements available in the, we can see available as per the composition. First is natural or rock cement. Second, Portland cement, which is a famous cement for Portland cement. Third is high alumina cement. Fourth is hydrolix hydrated lime. Fifth is pozzolan cement. Sixth is rapid hardening cement. And seventh is white cement. Eighth is corrosion resistant cement, controlled cement and special resisting cement. These are the 10 different types of cement on the basis of their composition. Let's see one by one. The first is natural cement or rock cement. The material formed by calcining the naturally occurring the mixture of calcareous material. What is the calcareous material? Calcareous material is nothing but the rich in the calcium, and argillaceous material, that is rich in the silica substance at low temperature with the sintering temperature is called as the natural cement. Second is Portland cement. This is very important cement where we are going to study the complete manufacture of this Portland cement. It can be defined as a product obtained intimately mixing togetherness calcareous and argillaceous substance together. This we have to understand very clearly. Calcareous material is nothing but the calcium material and argillaceous material is nothing but the silica material. This is a combination of the two, calcium and the silica material, where we can see the Portland cement is mostly mixture of the following compounds which having dicalcium silicate. We can see the formula 2 calcium oxide SiO2. The code we can see here C2S. What that C indicates the calcium, S indicates for silica. C2 means 2 molecules of calcium oxide. SiO2 was 1S indicate for the 1 silica. Second is tricalcium silicate. Here we can see 3 calcium oxide, 1 SiO2, which code is C3S, which indicates that 3 molecules of calcium oxide and 1 molecule of the silica, that is silicate combination is there. Likewise, tricalcium aluminate. Here aluminate is the code for the tricalcium aluminate is C3A. Second is tetracalcium aluminate, that is C4A. Tetracalcium aluminoferrite, which consisting of C4AF. Dicalcium aluminosilicate, which consisting of C2AS. You have to remember it very carefully, where the C code indicate for the calcium, S code indicate for the silica, A code indicate for the alumina, and F code indicate for the ferrite compounds. Here we can see again the Portland cement generally classified into 5 types of the Portland cement. One is type 1, regular or general use of Portland cement. It contains 40-60% of the C3S and 10-30% of C2S, 7-13% of the C3A. As you know that what do you mean by C3S? C3S is the tricalcium silicate, C2S is the dicalcium silicate, C3A is the tricalcium aluminate, where the code as already previously we seen in the previous slide, C indicate for the calcium, S indicate for the silica, A indicate for the alumina, and F indicate for the ferrite. And second, type 2, it's a moderate heat of hardening and sulfate resisting Portland cement. It is the characterized by the ratio of by higher ratio of C2S to C3S ratio, where the ratio should be the maximum. It can be hardness within the full strength of within a 28 days. Third one is type 3, high early strength Portland cement. This is the material used for the process higher lime to silica ratio than the type 1 elements, that is type 1 cement, where we can see percentage of C3S and C3A than regular Portland cement, which contains the higher percentage of C3S and C3A. Fourth one is low heat Portland cement. It contains lower percentage of tricalcium silicate, that is C3S, and tricalcium aluminate, that is C3A. With this we can say here it is evolved in which 15-35% less than that of regular high early strength of Portland cement. The fifth one is sulfate resisting Portland cement. It contains lower percentage of tricalcium aluminate than that of in ordinary cement. It is used when high sulfate resistance is required. It is good for seawater contact mass construction, specially exposed to the sea. So likewise, there are 5 different types of Portland cement here we can see. Next is high alumina cement. This is very important cement. It is also known as calcium aluminate cement. It is manufactured by the heating a mixture of limestone and bauxite, that is nothing but the, here we can say the alumina. Tricalcium aluminate, that is C3A, dicalcium silicate C2S, and tricalcium silicate C3S will be combination, that is composition is there. Next is hydraulic hydrated lime. It is made by burning limestone containing 10-20% of clay cement. it is a low placed product. Likewise, next is pozzolan cement. The name pozzolan was derived from the Pozzoli, a town in Italy. The pozzolan is a material capable of reacting with lime in presence of water at ordinary temperature to produce cementitious compounds. Naturally, this pozzolan occurs in the volcanic ash. This is also a very important cement, as we can see here. Rapid hardening cement. This is high early strength of the cement. It is setting time is same as that of normal cement. Next is white cement. It is a just variety of ordinary normal setting cement. It is useful for face, plaster to walls, concrete floors, etc. The whiteness is obtained by reducing the iron oxide to minimum. Here we can see the white cement, specially in which the iron oxide composition is very less as compared to the other. Next is corrosion resisting cement, and further controlled cement. Finally, special acid resisting cement. Likewise, there are 10 types of cements here we can see. Mostly we are interested to study the Portland cement. So with this, we can see here the basic definition of cement, importance of the cement, and classification of cement. So with this, in the next lecture, we are going to see directly manufacture of the Portland cement with a different step. Here I will stop here. In the next lecture, we will see some more points regarding the cement industry. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you so much.